magical butterfly in your stomach feeling.
And that's something so amazing to be a part of.
I was waiting for this day to come.
Some people think trainers just sit or shake paws. There's a lot more to it. Here at the AWL, our dogs get training daily to set them up to succeed in the outside world.
Good boy!
And just like dogs, we need training too.
Having just met him, I'm looking at his movements, his eye contact. You kind of have to read the dog in front of you. Every couple of weeks, I come in and do staff training. What we're trying to do is help them with understanding dog behavior and handling techniques. The more the staff know, the better the chance they can actually help the dogs get rehomed and live the best life they can.
Sit.
Yes.
One of my favourite things about the training is learning how much I actually didn't know. It's a really humbling experience. It really, really gives me loads more confidence.
Good girl, yes.
We cover pretty much all bases and it really does help out us and our animals.
Are you excited?
I'm very excited.
This could be the day.
We'll see what happens when we go inside.
Yeah.
Today is a very special day for dog lover Georgie, who has come to the AWL with mum Deb to fulfil a lifelong dream.
Good morning.
Hello.
Hello. I'm doing really well. How are you?
Good.
Okay, I see a little matchy matchy.
Who are we here for today?
Me.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're the one pushing for this.
I've wanted a dog my entire life, and after years and years and years and years and years and years of asking for a dog, I'm very excited that it's now.
It's not been a day, I don't think, where no. I don't have a dog. I'd really like a dog. Please, can I have a dog? Okay. From when she was this high. Yeah. So here we are.
Well, what changed? Why now? Why not yesterday or last year or 3 years from now?
The time is just right now. I think everything is kind of aligned.
Yeah.
And we're excited.
I think in year three, you had to write a persuasive essay and it was like, why I should have a dog. Like everything revolved around the possibility of this dog. She's worn us down and it's time for
it's
a dog.
It's deep-seated.
It is very deep-seated.
Oh, so many look at doggies. All of those ones. Oh, they're very cute.
They are all so cute.
And ponies.
Okay, I don't think we need a pony.
We could get
I think
a pony.
We'll settle on the dog.
So, tell us why you're here.
I'm here to hopefully get a dog.
Yes,
awesome.
Have you guys had dogs before?
No.
No, wow.
We've had every animal other than a dog.
Other than a dog.
So, are you finished school now? Are you working?
Yes, so I finished school a few years ago. I've also finished uni.
Oh, awesome.
I was working full time and then this year I've taken kind of a bit of a gap year. In my life at the moment, I've just done some amazing travels in different parts of Australia and overseas as well. And now I'm kind of back home, ready to settle into the next phase of life, getting back into work. And I think you could definitely say this is my dog era.
Is it going to be a family dog, but mainly?
Yeah, well,
it's yours. It's mine.
Your basically. Responsibility.
Yeah. And then when I move out, it'll come with me.
Okay,
well.
Cool.
Hopefully this will keep her here a little bit longer and the dog will love the whole family.
Yeah.
I am not looking forward to the day that either of my children move out, actually. I know it's coming. It's been coming for a while. But I think I will feel really confident that she's okay because she's got her best buddy by her side.
Let's talk about what you want out of a dog. Breed, size, age, what are we thinking?
So I'm kind of open to a whole host of things.
Cool.
I'm thinking more medium to large sized dog just because of the active kind of lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
In terms of age, I'm thinking on the younger side, you know, under five kind of thing.
Are you open to a puppy?
Yes. Mm-hmm. I think, now I have the time to kind of commit to a puppy, definitely, yeah.
So is there any deal breakers that we should know about?
I think the only thing I mentioned was if they're kind of limited physically.
Yeah. Okay,
just because I feel like I have the opportunity to give a dog an active lifestyle.
Yeah.
That's really good. Well, I feel like we've got a lot to go back and talk about and a lot of things to consider. So we might go and have a chat and we'll be back.
Okay. Perfect.
Great.
Alrighty.
Thank you.
Yeah. We've got mum Deb and daughter Georgie. So they're in a house at the moment, but Georgie is looking to eventually move out.
Yeah.
And wants to take the dog with her.
She seems like a very active, creative, crafty person. So I guess everything that she does, she kind of wants to involve the dogs.
So you guys thinking?
We do have Cohen.
Cohen?
Oh, look at him. So Cohen's been in the shelter for over 90 days now. He's 8 months old. He's a Staffy Terrier mix. Cohen was transferred to AWL as an injured stray with a badly broken leg. He has fully recovered and is now full of beans. He's a resilient young pup with a heart of gold, has a very sweet, loving nature and a very playful personality.
Oh, he's a good boy.
He is gorgeous.
He's a lovely dog, but he is, intense, which, you know, during that period of being really young, he's had surgery, he had to be crate rested, there's a lot of catching up that needs to happen with his training and socialisation.
Yeah, okay.
I think he might just be a little bit too much and a bit far out of their depth.
Yeah.
A bit hard to manage, I guess.
We also do have beautiful Diaz. Now, he's a bit younger, but he's a five-month-old Kelpie cross. Little Diaz came into AWL as part of an unwanted litter. Thrives on social interactions, whether it be humans or furry friends. Favourite things are chasing after toys, curling up for a cosy nap, and exploring new spaces.
He also likes chasing people.
Likes to chase people?
Not just toys. People are his toys. Yeah.
He's going to take some training, but in the environment that she's in and how active she is, I think he's an awesome match for her. We think we found you the perfect little guy.
Mm-hmm. Yes, his name's Diaz.
Okay.
Yes, okay.
He's very playful, loves to be energetic, and he's quite a little spunky fella.
Okay. Yes, he's full of life.
Okay.
He is a puppy.
Mm-hmm.
He's a good age puppy though.
Yeah.
He's about 5 months.
Okay.
It's going to be really important that he gets his training and you guide him to the where you want him to go instead of letting him go to his
own
devices, because he will.
Yeah.
So he is a Kelpie cross.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so he's active, obviously. Yeah. So if you're happy to take that on, I really think that he could be an awesome match for you.
Yeah, I'm excited about that. Yeah, it sounds
really good.
A lot of fun, and that's what I'm looking for. So, yeah.
Awesome.
Well, do we want to go meet Diaz?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Let's do it.
Yes, let's
come
go.
Oh, well, this sounds exciting, doesn't it?
I like the sound of a Kelpie and a puppy.
And a puppy.
Yeah. I think it sounds cheesy to say that animals are a piece of me, but it's just that I genuinely can't imagine my life without having animal interaction in it. I think animals have this superpower of being able to kind of cut through whatever you're worrying about or struggling with.
Sounds like you might be up for a game of tug-of-war or frisbee or something.
I would say most likely. As a kid, I was quite sick for the first few years of my life. I had a really low and compromised immune system. I particularly remember this one hospital stay. I think I was 5 at the time. I'd been in hospital for a few weeks and a family member came and brought me this Airedale Terrier dog toy, and I'd never seen anything like it. Ooh.
Oh, this is lovely.
Blankets. Little pond. I do think having the stuffed animals, it was that glimmer of hope. Because, you treat them like real animals as a kid. You brush them and you pretend to feed them and you take them on walks. Now to be at a point where I'm very much past Terry, even though I love him, the thought of making Terry into a real dog and being able to care for it in the same way will be very cool.
It's exciting. I really hope that this is the puppy for you.
What's this? Oh, what's this?
Whoa!
Here with me today is Diaz. He is a 3-month-old Kelpie mix. Kelpies are renowned for having loads of energy. They're working dogs. And Diaz is no exception. He has tons of that energy in puppy form.
You got loads of energy, aren't you?
It's really important. He gets lots of great training early on in his life and lots of things to do. So enrichment, toys, playtime, walks, lots of mental engagement. It's all gonna be a really important part of his life.
Hey, bud, beautiful boy.
So I can already see he's going to turn into the perfect companion for someone. I think as long as they have loads of time to accommodate for his energy, I think his future owners are right around the corner.
Hi, beautiful boy. Hi, darling.
You waited such a long, long time.
I know.
Now's the moment.
Please,
it's
good.
Very exciting.
I know, we'll get there. It's going to be very exciting.
I think it might be coming.
I hope it loves you.
Good boy. Come on, Diaz.
All right, Diaz, please don't be too cheeky.
We're going to go in here. Are you ready?
Here we go.
I think it could be close.
Here we go.
Georgie is only moments away from meeting Diaz and finally having a dog to call her own.
How long have you been waiting now? How many years?
23 and a half. Good boy. Come on, Diaz.
Here we go.
I think it could be close.
Here we go.
Hello.
How are you? Someone's very eager to meet you.
Yes. Sniffing the scent.
This is Diaz.
Hello, Diaz.
He's probably going to come straight up and say hello.
Hi.
And be very excited.
Hi.
Good boy.
Hello.
It's going to get crazy.
He's spiking.
Might be excited.
Diaz. Oh,
come on.
You want a treat?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. See, Georgie was engaging...
play?
Yeah, to distract him, which was nice.
Come on this way. Come on.
I feel Georgie's a bit of a wise old soul.
This way.
She's just got it together. She's ready to be out there in the world, and I think everything hinges for the next part of her next chapter on getting this dog and moving forward with this dog.
Oh, there's nice cuddles for me too.
He's very friendly.
He's just so friendly, aren't you? So friendly.
What about this
ducky? So friendly.
Come on.
Yeah, look.
Look. Yay. Ready? Ready? What if I put a treat in here? Look. Can you get that?
I actually really like that duck toy. It's actually really cool.
Mm. Oh, especially yeah, for a dog that likes to go for a run.
Yeah. I got one the other day because you get them from Bunnings for okay. Theo, and he loves it.
Yes, come here. Oh. Hello. You want a treat?
Okay. What do you think, Georgie?
I love
he
him.
Loves you.
Hello. Ready? Sit. Yummy. Yummy. Ready?
Yeah, you're so cute.
I really wonder if Deb is going to be that voice of reason. Like, we obviously know Georgie loves dogs, so I wonder is Mum going to kind of have that deciding vote?
He loves a good run.
Deb's got to be able to take care of this dog as well and mind him if Georgie goes away and things like that. So she's really got to be on board.
Come here. Come on.
Where are you? You got the zoomies.
You're cool.
You got the zoomies. He's got the zoomies.
Ready? Diaz.
He's got a lot of energy. I hope it's not really turning him off.
No, he's got...
Because he hasn't really stopped.
He hasn't stopped at all.
Ooh, that's a dog.
That is a dog, hey.
Jasper and Oliver have brought their parents to AWL for their very first family dog.
Do you reckon we're going to go home with a dog?
Oh, hope so.
Hi, how you going?
Not too bad. How you doing?
I'm Charlie.
Nice to meet you. I'm Viola.
Hi, Viola. How you going?
I'm doing amazing.
My husband,
hi
Nick.
There. How you going?
We've got Oliver and Jasper.
Which one's Oliver? Which one's Jasper?
I'm Jasper.
You're Jasper?
And I'm Oliver.
What face did you pull when I told you that we might be getting a dog?
I just did it.
How much do you want a dog out of 10, Jasper?
10.
10, yeah. And
actually, 100.
100? That's a big number.
Our family is going to have very much fun with the dog if we get one. If we don't get one, then I'll just say, oh, well, when I grow up, I'm going to get 14. When I grow up, I'm actually not going to get 14.
Well, tell me, why do you want a dog?
To play with and take on walks.
But Ollie's here. You can play with Ollie, can't you?
You're looking for unconditional love, aren't you?
Yes, yes. I think that, you know, raising kids is really hard. And, you know, they talk about sort of animals being really good for emotional regulation and that kind of thing. So that's sort of something that I think could be really handy in a household.
Thank you.
energetic pair Georgie and Diaz have not had a moment's rest.
Oh.
Where'd it go?
It's in your bed, come on.
You know where it is.
It's in your bed. In your bed.
Yeah, there we go. You can have pats in your bed. There's nice licks too.
Oh, that's nice.
That's a bit good of me.
That is nice, actually.
Good.
Hopefully we can try and keep the calm there and, like, that's a safe space.
Mm.
So let's see if this continues.
Licky, licky, licky. What are you doing? Are you sleeping?
There's needs and wants, aren't there? And I think for her this is a need. It's been a want for a very long time and now I think it is a need. I really see this as being an important milestone in her life. I do worry she'll be disappointed if it's not what she's got in her head.
Lick, lick, lick. That's
oh,
nice.
Georgie.
That's nice.
I can see Georgie really enjoying this company.
Yeah. Deb as well, I think she's probably breathing a sigh of relief. She's probably like, okay, he's settled down.
Yeah.
Like,
lick, lick, lick. Where are you going?
Good.
This way.
Look, they did ask for an active dog, so I do think that's what we've provided in the pen today.
But even looking at him, like, he's got this energy out. He's now more satiated. Like, his body language is looser. He's not like, oh, I need to get out all of my frustrations.
Absolutely.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes. How are you?
How's he going?
Good.
Yes,
so
he's been having
cute.
Lots of fun.
He loves running around.
Yeah.
I think after meeting Diaz, you see how high energy he is. He's very full on. Definitely thinking about the future with the dog. Obviously, living in our house at the moment, we do have a backyard, we have that space. But thinking when I do move out, that it will be a much smaller space. So yeah, there is a bit of concern with keeping his energy, you know, entertained.
This is the sort of pace you want for your walks?
Yeah, we can go faster. Ready? Can you go faster?
Go fast.
Speedy! Good boy! Back to walkies?
I'm coming too.
Hey, drop.
No. We see a lot of first-time dog owners come through the doors at AWL, looking to open their hearts and homes to a rescue dog. It is quite common that we see first-time dog owners really miss those key communication cues that the dog gives to them.
Oh, you're going to be crazy now.
He wants
to play. Oh, he wants to play.
Part of our job is to pass on to new owners how to read those cues and make sure that they're able to meet the needs of those dogs and have the best possible relationship.
Scissors, paper, rock.
Chop, chop, mummy wins.
Eagerly awaiting the matchmakers are Jasper and Oliver, who are looking for another sibling to bring home with mum and dad.
There's lots of smiles in this room.
Yeah.
There was lots of nerves this morning. There was kind of, I was like, oh, are you feeling okay? He's like, oh, what if we don't get a dog?
Oh, there's no pressure. You can come here as much as you like.
Exactly
every day.
Exactly right.
Yep. So why now? Why is now a good time to take a dog home?
Ollie's just started school this year and we're sort of out of that really young kid phase and we have a bit more time to devote to bringing an animal yep. into the family. I like the idea that the boys, as they grow up, will have other companionship that's not, you know, parents.
I want a dog because when you're upset, it can understand your feelings and when you don't want to play with your brother, you have someone else to play with.
And who do you think is going to build the strongest connection with the dog?
Me.
That was really quick.
So great. We've looked after quite a few of our friends' dogs mm-hmm. and from, you know, the sausage to the really big Labradoodle. And obviously when they first come into your house, they're a little bit nervous. But they just migrate to Jasper and they
pick
kind
up
of follow
energy.
Him around.
Mm. And when they're upset, I just give them the space that they need.
Do you feel like you've got a special connection with dogs, Jasper?
Yeah.
Yeah?
A little dog whisperer, perhaps?
Yeah, exactly.
I think that's actually given us a lot of confidence to actually get a dog ourselves. We're complete dog novices.
Okay, so really
this is your first time dog owners?
Yeah. I'm certainly nervous, not owning dogs before. We don't know what we don't know. And I think looking after some of our friends' dogs has kind of shown us, you know, there is quite a lot to welcoming a dog into the house.
It's like getting another sibling.
How about age?
I want a young dog.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like just puppy young or just young adult?
We don't want it too old.
Yeah,
okay. So it doesn't die straight away.
We definitely consider a puppy, okay. But anything with maybe like 8 years.
Puppy up to 8 years.
Yeah, that's still a big gap for us. That's great.
Pretty broad.
And any other deal breakers?
Super big, super small, super big.
Yeah.
What's super big?
Greyhound and above.
Okay. So who's going to be making the final decision today?
Me.
Are we okay with that, Ollie?
No.
So this family is novice to dogs, as in they've never owned a dog in their life.
Okay, so what are they looking for in a dog?
Very open. Even when they said, you know, deal breakers or certain things that they would prefer, it was still quite flexible.
What do you think about Saenra? So Saenra has been with us for quite a long time now, over 120 days. She was a year and a half staffy cross. Can live with kids and other animals with a slow and steady introduction. Personality points, she can be nervous and shy at first, an affectionate foodie, the perfect mix of polite and crazy. Mm,
she's also really struggling being here.
Yeah.
So we're seeing more of the hyperactivity from her than we are seeing that nice, calm, cuddly dog that we once had.
Yeah. You know, I would love to get Saenra out of here for how long she's been here. I'm just, for a novice family, I just don't know if we pop her in the pen. If something happens, they won't know how to manage it.
Is there anything else you're thinking?
I was thinking little Travis. So Travis is a 7-month-old D6 male staffy cross. Travis arrived at AWL as an unclaimed stray. He was in a bad way with severe kennel cough and bone deformities from a poor diet and malnutrition. Thankfully, he has made a full recovery and is now ready to find his forever home.
He is a very sweet dog.
He's social.
Yeah, he's a great option.
And he's built like his confidence a lot here at shelter.
Yeah.
He was quite timid and shy.
Yeah, and he still can be at times.
Yeah, at times
he can be, like I was wrestling with him the other day on the grass. Like he can be that cheeky, playful puppy.
Oh, yeah, sure.
They just need to give him that time.
I think also with Travis, the fact that he has had a successful match before, it would be great to get him into a home.
Yeah, Travis is a good fit for them, I think. Are we all excited?
Yeah.
Okay, you did put your faith in us, so we think we have found you personality-wise the best dog, and I can say that because not that we have favourites, but he is a bit of my favourite.
Oh, it's a boy dog.
Yes. Oh, man. His name is Travis.
Travis.
That's a good name.
Yes. He'll match you guys so well, you two boys. He will love to run around and play fetch in the backyard. You will probably have to teach him.
Yeah.
Because he is a 7-month-old.
Oh, wow.
So that's like
puppy kind of.
Yes. Yeah.
Breed-wise, he's a staffy mix.
Yep. We've really tried to hit home on the temperament for you guys.
Yeah.
And he is just, he's a really good match for everything that you guys wanted in a dog.
Cool.
Oh, brilliant. Yeah.
The most important question for you two, do you want to meet Travis?
Yes. Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yes, you don't seem very excited.
Yeah?
Yes. Yeah? All right, let's go meet Travis.
Let's go. Wow, you're a beautiful boy.
One thing I love about Travis is he's a very reserved dog, especially for his young age.
You'll avoid that.
When Travis first came to us, he was very shut down. He was very nervous and he was very cautious of his surroundings, which is very normal for a dog that's first coming into a shelter. But in the short time that he's been here, he's grown so much confidence and he's just come out of his shell completely. He's almost an entirely different dog. He would suit pretty much any family, just as long as they're willing to go slow with him. And he grows and grows more on you every day.
Oh, Travis!
Hey!
And a puppy. What do you think about that?
I think that's awesome. I actually really love that idea. I think getting a dog is right for our family because we have a lot of love to give a dog. We've got a home that we'd love to share with a dog. We've got two kids who are active and really keen to be part of a dog's life. You know, and I think that we'll be able to provide a safe and welcoming environment for a dog.
All right. Oh, this is it. This is it.
We've looked after loads of dogs. I think dogs just find the special connection to me. I like that they like me the best, but not him. Well, I wonder, I'm just nervous when he's coming.
Why are you nervous?
When is he coming? If we want the dog, it'll probably come up to me and he'll go, sniff, sniff. It'll sniff me.
Hi,
Travis. Good boy.
I keep looking under the door to see if I can see the little
legs.
Mummy,
you can move over.
Oh, are we having a...
No, I don't
think there's
anything
there. Come on, that's it.
But it, in the lounge room, so it's there just...
Oh, there we go.
So excited. I know, you don't need to jump on me.
Staffy pup Travis is a short stroll away from potentially meeting his forever family.
Come
on, that's it.
Oh, there we go. Oh.
Hello, everybody. This is Travis.
Oh, gorgeous.
It's a beautiful colour, isn't
it? He is beautiful.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Let him have a little sniff.
Okay. He's definitely going to fit on my bed.
You know, I'm excited to see how Jasper matures with dog ownership. I know he's good with dogs and dogs love him, but I really want him to get to a point where he's comfortable in terms of how to handle a dog out in the real world.
And we just keep calling him Travis.
Travis!
Come on, Travis!
Come here, Travis!
Jasper's so keen, isn't he?
Jasper's very
keen. So, and Oliver.
Travis!
He's waiting. He's waiting.
Travis!
He's waiting.
Come here,
Mister.
Hello.
Come here. Travis.
Would you need to, you know, teach them as well with recall? If you just keep saying the name over and over and over, it loses its gusto.
Yep.
Like when people go, sit. The dog's like, what? Huh?
What are you? Yeah.
It just becomes a noise.
He keeps on going to the door.
Yeah.
That's okay.
The people that he knows went out the door. So,
yeah.
Jasper is not the kid that openly sort of falls over and cries. And I feel like maybe having a dog would be really good to help him express emotions when he might not to an adult or to another person.
Do you think he's the right dog?
I don't know, buddy.
What do you think, Jasper?
Oh, I don't know.
I wonder what reservations Jasper has.
Because he's not all over him being cuddly, right?
Yeah. I think, like everything, Jazzy, it'll take a little bit of time to get to know each other. I'm nervous that it won't have a connection with the kids.
Travis, look, tree.
If it was sort of hesitant, I think maybe that wouldn't be the right dog for us.
I think he really likes me.
He does follow you around a bit, doesn't he?
He followed me out.
Maybe you're the closest in size.
Do you think Jasper's feeling a bit underwhelmed?
If they played with him, he'd be all over him.
Yeah. Hello.
Straight past us.
It's all right, Jazzy.
I'm really nervous.
That's all right. Feeling all right?
Maybe. I think so.
It's okay. They're here to help us.
Lovebirds Josh and Mia love nothing more than dogs. And each other.
From the way you two are standing, I'm assuming partners, friends, boothang.
Few years.
Partners.
Yeah.
Few years. Who wants to tell me how you guys met?
Okay. I talk. You talk.
I can talk.
We talk. Know. I talk.
We can speak in unison.
Okay. 3, 2, 1.
So we met online in the pandemic.
And Mia sent the first message.
The message was...
Do you want to be rebellious in public and hold hands?
He's all looking at you with the love eyes too. I'm like, oh my god!
You got
gosh.
The like awooga eyes.
Jamaican Looney Tune style.
Too cute.
I've had friends or cousins ask, you know, like why do you like that? Like, he just gets me.
We're very happy together, I'd say.
Dedicated.
Yeah.
Dedicated.
You are mine and I'm yours.
Yeah.
Dog whisperer Jasper is having a hard time connecting with Staffy pup Travis.
I don't know if Travis is the right dog.
Oh, really?
I feel like he wants to, like, kind of run around and play.
He does.
They don't know how to... They can't read his behaviour, yeah.
Do you feel a bit disappointed that he's not super all over you, Jazz?
Yeah.
It's hard to know what a dog wants when you're a first-time dog owner. Mm. We know Travis wants to play and they'd be better off running around.
But then we've also told them that he's timid, so they're doing the right thing and sitting.
Yep.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello, hello. Oh, he's going for a run.
Going for a run.
He's trying to find things to do.
You know, it's just them learning how to read dogs and their body language.
Confuse bark with food, especially puppies. Hi, Travis.
Oh, you want one?
Oh, yes.
You want one? Yes, you do.
Yeah, yummy. Nice flat hands.
Yeah,
perfect.
Hello.
Travis.
Good boy.
Travis.
Oh, quick flop.
Having a chill.
Doesn't want to kiss.
Oh, you won one. You won it.
Yeah. Are you guys happy if I head out? I'll just be at the door.
Good boy.
Oh, thank you so much.
Stop it. This is so cute.
Travis.
Not too, rough with him, please.
Travis.
It's nice to see the kids playing with Travis. Maybe that connection wasn't 100% there straight away. I hope it's enough for them to see that he is the right dog for them.
Travis.
Yep.
Romantics Josh and Mia are one step closer to welcoming a fur baby into their lives.
Hi.
Hi. Oh, hello.
How are we?
Hello.
I am so nervous.
You're nervous? Oh. I'm nervous.
Don't be
Taylor.
Hi. My name's Juliet. So are we nervous because dogs mean so much? Why?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what does a dog mean to you?
Early on, I was holding back on my dog obsession because it really is an obsession.
And then it all came rushing out.
My family's had Harvey, who's a terrier mix. Mm-hmm. We've had a Rottweiler, Macy, a boxer named Shine.
I love that. Team Roddy.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Yes,
I love Roddy's.
Yes, love my Roddy's.
Do you have a favourite dog breeds?
Oh, like several.
I love. Pulls out the scroll.
Yeah. Let me just. So this is Dog Quest. This is one of seven volumes. This is a little passion project of mine to take photos with all the breeds, all 300 plus that are officially recognized. I'm always on the prowl.
What size?
Probably about small to medium.
I guess anything from like,
that's a decent sized dog, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
And hopefully cuddly, chill type. Good for apartment living.
Okay. Yeah. Do you think you guys are going to be on the same page about what you're looking for in a dog?
I reckon. Look, if Mia's happy, I'm happy.
Oh, good. So, that's the way you should be.
That's the perfect thing to say.
I will get some cuddles, but number one, it will be Mia's dog, Mia's special little one.
My baby.
Yeah.
How was it go?
Good, we have really a really nice couple. It's their first fur baby.
Nice.
Together. Yeah. They've had many, many dogs previously.
Mia is very dog savvy.
Yeah, okay, that's good.
Yeah.
What are you guys thinking?
Well, since Mia did mention one of her favourite breeds were Rottweilers, I immediately thought of Girlie.
Look at that.
She's so
specimen
sweet.
Specimen of a dog.
Girlie is a 2-year-old D-sex female Rottweiler crossbreed. She was surrendered to the AWL Inspectorate Division. She was thin and nervous when she arrived, but is slowly coming out of her shell. Favourite things are treats of all kinds, walkies and giving kisses.
Nah. Hmm. She's a sweet girl. What's her temperament like?
She's very timid.
Yeah.
And she's not super cuddly just yet. She can be quite aloof at times. And they did say that they really want a cuddly dog.
They did say cuddly.
Oh, she's a good option. Mm. We do have Angel as well.
She is such an angel.
Oh, look at her ears.
So Angel's 7 years old, Staffy Cross, surrendered to AWL after her owner didn't have time for her anymore, which is really sad. Favourite things are fluffy toys, mealtime, and all the pets she can get.
Angel is lovely. She does have two medical disclaimers, though. So she's got the disclaimer for her cauliflower ears, and she does have allergic skin. If you don't keep on top of skin issues, they can be quite expensive.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I guess I'm leaning more towards Girlie. You know, she's only 2 years old. They've had a Rottweiler before. I know she's a little bit timid, but she has come leaps and bounds here. She's a lot more confident.
And she's not a destructive dog in her kennel. She's a chill dog.
So go, Girlie?
Yeah.
Girlie, yep.
Good luck.
Thank you. Well, we think we found you quite a perfect darling.
Yes. She's a girl.
Her name is Girlie.
Girlie.
She can be a bit shy at times.
Yeah, that's fair.
Just a little same.
Definitely take it slow with her. Don't expect, you know, that instant connection straight away in the pen. She may take a bit of time to come over and say hi.
So Girlie is a Rottweiler cross.
She's a baby.
So she's about 2 years old.
Mm. Oh, perfect.
Oh, she's perfect.
Absolutely perfect.
Still young.
She's gaining confidence every day as well. I think she'd be a great match for you guys.
Yeah. Oh, fantastic. Thank you so much.
It's okay.
So you're feeling good about this then, I'm assuming?
Yes.
I'm so excited. Do you guys have any questions for us?
When can we meet Girlie?
Can we go now? I'm so ready. Oh my gosh, she's like a dream come true.
That's perfect. And she sounds like such a sweetie as well.
A baby.
Adorable name.
Girlie.
Watching me interact with a dog, there's something fun about it. Like, I feel like a secondhand joy.
Oh my gosh. This is going to be our baby.
A little baby.
It's like a bubbly, fizzly kind of feeling.
Thank you. Oh my gosh. Ooh. It's so cute.
What a fit out.
A lot of kids growing up have like diaries or journals. I had a dog. Dogs can just like understand so much and not a single word is spoken.
Traffic light?
Yeah.
Over the past year or so, I received a diagnosis for a neurological condition. It affects how I perceive sound and light and texture as well. It also affects the way I socialize. Here we go. I have to keep the pillow on my lap. That stops me from jumping up.
Any tippy taps will be muffled.
I thought I was just, I mean, I was always called weird or like odd, but the diagnosis definitely put to rest a lot of worries I had. I've come to own the weirdness. It's just part of who I am.
I'm like looking under the door, just waiting.
I'm so ready.
I hope she
knows her presence is anticipated and that she has so much love waiting for her.
Hi, honey. Hello, I'll give you some treats. Hi. Oh, you're so cute.
So this is Girlie. She is a two-year-old Rottweiler mix. Rottweilers are quite relaxed, laid-back dogs. They do, of course, like all dogs, need to have a run around, but then also have that time to lay down. That was really good timing. So Girlie came to us quite timid, and it has taken some time just to gain her trust, but we're hoping that during her time here, she sort of understands that people will not hurt her anymore, and she will be surrounded with love for the rest of her life.
Good girl.
I see her. Yep.
She coming?
She's coming.
All right, you ready? Girlie.
Oh, I see paws.
Oh my gosh, okay, hang on, no, deep breaths.
Game faces.
Game face, everyone.
Hello, Girlie.
This is Girlie.
Hello.
Oh my goodness. She'll have
she's a bit of a sniffer at first. I don't think
she's been here before. She's a little bit timid when meeting new people, so just taking a little bit slow with her.
That's okay.
Mm-hmm. A bit shy.
Yeah, but
she does that
tail.
Startle response as well. Anytime you move your hand, she's like, oh. I know, you can't come out with me. You can't come out with me. Yeah.
Oh!
That was so close. Bro. My heart. You are not catching that dog as she gets out.
Hi, Girlie. I hope she comes over.
She will. She'll just need some warm-up time.
Yeah.
If I was in a room with two strangers, I would probably be feeling the same way. My social battery runs out very quickly. Even still now, I need to take a moment to remove myself from a situation. Sometimes I need to go to the other room or just call it an early night.
Oh, Girlie. Hi.
Oh, her favourite person has run away.
Oh, they're understanding of how she would be feeling.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is nice.
Oh, she seems kind of stressed.
Mm.
She keeps looking for a way to exit. Having that unique company that only a dog can bring is something that I've definitely missed.
Hi.
Girlie is stressed.
Oh, I hope she doesn't try to jump that.
Oh.
Uh-oh. She's freaking out.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
She's gonna jump.
Okay.
Oh, bye-bye, Girlie.
And she's gone.
Is someone gonna come and get her?
Mia and Josh have not had a fairy tale first meeting with Rottweiler Girlie.
Help.
I don't know what to do.
Has she gone off-roading?
Yeah, she went into that.
Oh, no.
I wasn't sure if we should, like...
We didn't want to stress her out.
For me, a dog. It's another step in our relationship.
Girlie! Hi! How do I get you out of this?
Do you need a hand?
Girlie!
There we go.
But for me, that dog represents a lot. I really think that there is an aspect of being completed by a dog.
Were you guys happy if we try sitting up on the stairs here?
Yeah.
It might be in the middle of everything, so she'll probably...
Bless you.
We really just want to see Girlie come up and interact with both Mia and Josh.
There you go. Girlie! Hey!
Good girl.
I'm going to cover this before she dives straight in there. Good job.
Oh, I thought about it.
Yeah.
There you go. She's getting a lot more comfortable with you. That's amazing.
Good girl.
Okay. She's taking food for them. That's good.
Hey, Girlie.
Mia's been so excited about this dog.
Hello.
If it doesn't work out today, it'll be devastating.
Hi. It's okay. Yeah.
Oh, she's a bit wary.
Yeah.
Girlie hasn't at all taken anything from Josh this whole time.
No.
I want to pet her, but I don't want to scare her.
Yeah, she'll come round. I really liked Girlie. I feel like if we had a few extra hours, a couple more days, we could definitely forge a connection.
Girlie, hey.
I don't know what to say.
I like her. Do you like me?
I think she does like you.
Does she like you?
I'm not sure.
Busy afternoon for the boys.
I think when Travis first came in, I was probably expecting more of a connection. I'll just make them wraps. I felt that Travis maybe wasn't quite as excited to see us as I was hoping.
So we've looked after many dogs and they like me, and I don't want this dog to be the one that doesn't like me. Oh, I forgot some.
You know, we had to talk about whether Travis was the right dog for us.
We had to think about, are we going to leave him at the shelter or take him home? But we decided to take it off!
Travis, come.
Good boy!
Good boy!
I think he is the type of dog we were hoping for. And actually, I think the shelter probably picked us better than we picked for ourselves. I love coming home from work and he's the happiest thing at the front door waiting for me.
Sit. Travis, drop. Yes, good boy.
Some mornings we find Travis pining outside Jasper's door until Jasper gets up.
That means Travis likes me more.
Go on. Oh, yeah, good work.
If I had to rate Travis out of 10, I would rate him 10 out of 10.
I would rate him 11 out of 10.
I would rate him 100 out of 10.
Cup of tea, Josh?
It was very exciting to meet Diaz. He's very cute. But there was slight concern that Diaz's energy would be a bit too much.
I know.
There's a bug in there.
It's obviously something I've been thinking about and wanting for so long that you wanted to make sure the moment and dog was exactly right. In the end, we decided to bring Diaz home and we've changed his name to Rocky. Rocky!
Come here.
Who wants a belly rub?
Hello.
His energy is absolutely non-stop, but so is mine, so it's kind of okay. It's kind of been the perfect match that, yeah, we go and spend all our energy and then come home and relax together.
Let's go.
I see an incredibly happy daughter now that she's brought Rocky home.
Come on.
He goes everywhere with her. It's just been the best thing that ever happened.
That's a big call.
It is.
I've absolutely fallen in love with Rocky. He's the perfect addition and can't really imagine him not being here now.